In the last video, we looked at the Background tab of the Appearance Preferences. In this video, we're going to look at the Fonts tab. To show how this works a little better, I'm going to open up a few more windows. I'm going to open up the Update Manager. I'm going to edit my preferences to always show security updates. Apply. Now we have something in the window to see. I'm also going to open up the File Manager. And a terminal. The first thing I want to do is change the application font. It's set at 9. I am going to change that to 18. And here's what we see change. In the Appearance Preferences window, we see the tabs changed, as well as the text in the Appearance Preference window, including the buttons at the bottom. Looking at the Update Manager, we see that the menu at the top is larger, as well as all the text in this window, as well as down at the bottom, this status bar. If we look at the taskbar at the bottom, that is all a larger screen. If I click on the menu, we see that the menu text is all larger as well. Going into the terminal window, we see that the tabs are larger, but the text itself is not. And going up into the File Manager, we see that the menu at the top is a larger text, as well as the buttons. And the tooltips are larger as well. The icons and the text in the window did not change, nor did the text or the icons on the desktop. With all this text still larger, let's go back to the Appearance Preferences. We see rendering down below, but if we click down on this button, it says Details. The first thing at the top, we see resolution 96 dots per inch. If I change this to something like 150, we see all the text gets larger, including the text on the desktop and in the File Manager. I'm going to change this back to 96. And we have something here called smoothing. There's three choices: none, grayscale, and subpixel. Changing this to none, we see our text change a little bit, and then into grayscale, it's slightly better. And I've got an LCD, so this would be the optimal for my monitor. The hinting, that is to improve the quality of the fonts in the small size with a low screen resolution. The default for my monitor is slight. We can set this at full. And this last one, subpixel order, this is hardware dependent. So I will let the Mate desktop choose this one for me. And I'm going to close this window. Going back to the Appearance Preferences, under the rendering, we've got Monochrome, Best Shapes, Best Contracts, and Subpixel Smoothing. The Monochrome shows fonts only in black and white. The gray parts will not show, so your font may look a little jagged. I can see a little bit with the D's here on the desktop. Best Shapes. This one's meant to be used if you've got a cathode ray tube, CRT. Although many of the screens today are flat screens, I'm sure there are still a few CRTs being used today. Down here, Best Contrast. The people that would get the most out of this are people with visual impairments. It's set up to work best with the visual impairment software. And the last one, Subpixel Smoothing for LCDs. I've got an LCD screen, so I will choose this one. I'm going to change this application font back to the default of 9. And we see everything change back. Let's skip down to the desktop font. When I change this, I'm going to change the font size to 18. When I click OK, we see that it changes the font size on the desktop. The icons themselves did not change, nor did anything else change in the windows we have open. Change that back to 10. Then we've got the window title font. I can change that one to 18 again. And we see just the titles in our windows have changed. While we're here, I should mention that we can change this font to something else. Let's say we change this to Parisia, oblique, and we'll keep it at 18. We see that the font itself changes, not just the size. I'll change this back. And down at the bottom, we've got this fixed font. If I change this one, make that 15, okay, we see that it changes in the terminal. Now, this also affects what's in the text, accessories, text editor. We see that this one is larger too. Changing this now to 18. We see the text in the text document has gotten larger as well as what's in the terminal. While we're on here, I also want to mention in the terminal, if I hold down Control and hit the plus, we see our text gets larger, and Control minus makes this smaller. This does not work the same way in our text document. If I hold down Control plus, nothing happens. So we can close this window, close without saving. And I've changed this now to make it small. If I close my terminal and reopen it, we see that it returns to the size that we assigned it in the appearance preference window. So when we use the Control plus and minus, this is just temporary for the window that we have open. Once we close and reopen it, it will go back to the size in the appearance preferences. I'll change this one back to 10. Now this last one that we skipped over is the document font. It's set as the same Noto Sans 10. When we open up something like LibreOffice Writer, you'd expect that to be a document font. Even before we start typing text, we can see right up here in the toolbar, the font is set as Liberation Serif 12. The reason LibreOffice Writer is different is it overrides this document font of Noto Sans and puts in its own value. That's why it appears like this document font doesn't do anything. It is set as the default, but the programs that would use this document font as the default override that default font. I'm going to close these windows. Other things I'm going to say about fonts are, if we open up the menu, Software Manager, we can type fonts up in the search. And here we see we can install Microsoft TrueType fonts just by clicking that. Another way to add fonts is to go to the internet. Favorites. I'm going to search on free fonts. First thing we see is 1001 free fonts. And here are a few examples of some fonts that we could download. I'm going to choose Army Stencil. Then I'm going to come down and look at a couple of them. We see this top one says this is donationware. You can download it and donate to the designer. This one here called cutouts, this one's free for personal use. And the one right below that says free. Let's try this one. It says free, download. I will save the file. Looking down a little further, we also have one called Boston Traffic and Due Date. Those also are free. Let's download Boston Traffic. Save the file. I'm going to look in my downloads folder. They're zipped. I need to extract all. I'll extract here. And this one as well. Extract here. Now we need to move these into where we keep the fonts. And the fonts can be found up in User, Share, because it's for all the users. And then we should have something called fonts. There's fonts. We can already see a few folders in here. I want to right click and create a new folder for my 1001 fonts, but I can't create a folder here. What we need to do, I'm going to click back into Share. I need to open this folder as an administrator. Now I need to type in the password. Now I can create the folder, 1001 fonts. I'm going to move in my two fonts. Now if I want to change the window title font to one of our new fonts, there's our Boston Traffic right here. Click OK, and our titles are now updated to the new Boston Traffic. I will change that back. Noto Sans.